In this beginner assignment, we're going to make a very simple but playable 2D game to use many of the basic concepts from the beginner tutorial modules. We'll be making a 2D UFO game where we'll be collecting gold nuggets. We'll see how to create new game objects, add components to these game objects, set the values on their properties, and position these game objects in the scene to create a game. In our game, the player will control a UFO flying around the game board in a top-down 2D view. We'll move the UFO using physics and forces. We'll look at the input from the player through the keyboard, and we'll use those inputs to apply forces to the UFO, making it move in our scene. We'll see how to detect contact between the UFO and the pickup game objects and use these events to collect the pickup game objects. When we're done, we'll have made a simple UFO game where the player controls the UFO with the keyboard, picks up and counts special collectible objects, displays the current count, and ends the game when all of the game objects have been picked up. To complete this project, we'll use custom created 2D art assets, which can be downloaded from the Unity Asset Store. Let's begin by creating a new project. First, open the Unity Editor if you haven't done that already. You can create a new project by choosing File, New Project. This will bring us to the home screen. On the home screen, you can create a new project either by hitting the blue Create New Project button in the center of the window, or by clicking the New button at the top of the window. The first thing that we need to do is to give our project a name. I'm going to call the project UFO Game. The next thing we need to do is set the destination or path to our new project. I'm going to put this new project on my desktop. You'll see we have a choice to set the project preferences to either 3D or 2D mode. Since we're working in 2D, I'm going to click 2D. This will set the preferences for the Unity Editor to useful defaults for creating 2D games. For more information on working in 2D, please see the information linked below. Now, click the Create Project button to create our new project. Unity will create a new empty scene for us to work in. The first thing we'll need to do is to download and import our art assets from the Unity Asset Store. To access the Asset Store, choose Window, Asset Store, or use the keyboard shortcut Command 9 on Mac or Control 9 on Windows. The Asset Store is a service that Unity Technologies provides where creators can both buy and sell assets to make games. These include art, music, scripts, effects, all the way up to complete games and projects. Unity also publishes content to the Asset Store, including teaching projects like this one, to help you learn how to make games. By default, the Asset Store is opened as a docked tab. Let's undock the tab so that we can expand the window. In the upper right corner of the expanded Asset Store window, we'll see a listing of asset categories. At the bottom, we should find Unity Essentials. Expand this category and we'll find a subcategory called Sample Projects. Within Sample Projects, we'll find an item called 2D UFO Tutorial. Click on the item title to open it. Once the page loads, we'll see a download button in the upper left corner. Click on the download button to begin downloading the assets. The download button will be replaced by the percentage of the download completed once we click on it. Once the download is complete, we'll see a dialog labeled Importing Complete Project. This warns us that importing a complete project will overwrite our current project settings. In this case, because we've just created a new project, this is fine. Click the Import button to continue. Next, we'll be given a choice of which assets we would like to import into our project. The default is all, which is what we want, so go ahead and click Import. Close the Asset Store window. We now have our new project with our assets imported and the default new empty scene open. Before creating anything in the new scene, we need to save our scene. We can save our scene by choosing File, Save Scene, or by using the keyboard shortcut Command S on Mac or Control S on Windows. I'm going to save this scene in the Assets directory in the folder called Scenes. I'm going to call the scene Main. We can now see in our Scenes folder the scene called Main. It's worth noting that the completed prefabs, scenes, scripts, and sprites folders were all created when we imported our asset package. The completed folder contains a completed version of the project, which you can refer to if you get stuck. Great! That's the end of our first lesson. In our next lesson, we're going to lay out our play field.